So good afternoon, my name is K. Praveen Kumar. I am working as assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, KG Reddy College of Engineering and Technology. Now I want to explain about the parabola, how to construct a parabola with different methods. Now I want to explain about the parabola, construction of parabola, construction of parabola. So in this we have three types. Three types of methods. Number one is general method. Number two is tangent method. Number three is oblong method. So these are the three methods for construction of the parabola. Now we have to go for general method. We have to go for construction of parabola with general method. So in this general method, we have a problem. Number one is general method. Problem is construct a parabola with a distance of focus, with a distance of focus 50 from directrix. Also draw a normal and tangent to the curve at a distance of 40 from directrix. So this is a question. Now here the given data is, in the solution given is focus F is equal to 50. Now its eccentricity method, its eccentricity E is equal to 1. That means eccentricity is equal to 1 of the parabola, Now, for this, we have to draw the directrix. AB. You locate a midpoint of this C. Perpendicular to this directrix, draw the horizontal line, which is called a axis. This is called the axis. CD, this is called the axis. This is a directrix. Now, this construction of the parabola is same as ellipse. Only the eccentricity value is different. So first we have to locate the focus F. So the focus from the directrix is 50. This is the focus. This is the 50 distance. 50 distance. So now this is 50. Now the eccentricity is equal to what here? The eccentricity A is equal to 1. A is equal to 1. So that means what? It becomes also we can written as 1 by 1, which is equal to 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 means the distance from C to F we have divided into 2 equal parts. We divide into 2 equal parts. So this is assuming V. This is assuming V. Now from V, draw a line perpendicular to CF. From V, draw a line perpendicular to CF. Draw a line perpendicular to CF some distance. Now VF is a radius. V as a center, draw the arc. Draw the arc. So this is assuming E. This is E. Now we have to join from E through from C to E and extend it. Join CE and extend. CE and extend. Now same from V, you divide into some equal and unequal parts from V towards right side. So same regiming, this is 1, this is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. Now from V, draw a line parallel to VE, it touches the this one, 1 dash, and also extend downward direction. From 2, draw a line up 2 dash and extend it. From 3, draw the line 3 dash, also extend. From 4, 4 dash, 5 dash and extend on both directions. 6 dash, downward extend. 7 dash and extend it. Now you take the radius 1 1 dash is the radius, F is the center, draw an arc on this side, also this side. So that is 1 1 dash is the radius, F is the center, draw the arc here and same distance here, also same distance. Now 2 2 dash is the radius, F is the center, draw the arc, then it will be intersecting at this point only, same distance, this also same. Next 3 3 dash is the radius, F is the center, draw an arc here and here, also then here. 4 4 dash is the radius, F is the center, draw an arc here and this one. 5 5 dash is the radius, same, F is the center, draw an arc here and here. Similarly we can draw 6 6 dash radius, F is the center, draw an arc here and here. 7 7 dash is the radius, F is the center, draw the arc here and same here. Now we have to join through all these points, through V. This is one point, another point, here also same, one point, these are the points for joining. So these are the points. So through all these points, we have to join. This is the P1, P2, this is the point is P3, P4, P5, P6, P7. This is P1, this is the P1 dash, P2 dash, P3 dash, P4 dash, P5 dash, P6 dash, P7 dash. Now we have to join through all these points through V. We have to join all these points through V. And towards downward direction also. So this is our parabola. This is our required parabola. Also, we can extend this also. Can extend this also. So, this curve is called a parabola. This is a parabola. So, this is called a parabola curve. Parabola. This curve is called a parabola. Now, how can we draw the normal tangent? Now, take a distance 40 from directrix. Take 40 from directrix. So, this is a distance 40. From this is the 40. From here, draw the vertical direction. This line cuts this curve at this point. Now, we have to join this point and F. This point and F. And this we can take it as M. Join M and F. Now, draw a line perpendicular to MF from F towards on the directrix. So, this we have to draw the line perpendicular to this one. This line is, this is a perpendicular. It will be intersecting this directrix at this point. This is the T. Now, join T and M and extend it. Join T and M and extend it. We have to join T and M. Extend. This is our tangent. This is called a tangent. And a normal. So, at this point, perpendicular to the tangent, we have to draw a line through M. Through M, this is draw a line perpendicular to this. This is called a normal. This is called a normal. So, this line is called a normal. This is a normal. So, this is our construction of a parabola by using a general method. Thank you.